So I'm interviewing Peter Hooton today, the author of this fascinating book, The Boot Room Boys, the unseen story of Anfield's conquering heroes. And a very kind of secretive thing, was it? You know, when you were growing up, what's the boot room?
Yeah.
It was like this room that nobody... And actually in the book, the first time you see a photograph of it, I think I'm right to say, is when Shankly and Paisley have gone. Yeah. And there's the picture of Roy Evans and I think soon as Phil Thompson. Yeah. And you can see the bags, you see the Patrick bags going in, the goal bags. Because prior to that, you know...
People weren't allowed in, really. Players certainly were reluctant to knock on the door because they'd just get a wisecrack at them, you know.
Like the headmaster's office.
Yeah, it was the head, yeah. And managers used to go in, and Tommy Docherty used to say, he used to love going to the boot room, but you got a drink and that's all you'd ever got at Anfield, meaning they never got any points, you know. I think Elton John went in, and it's in the book, one of the quotes is like that he felt more nervous going into the boot room to meet all these characters than he did playing in front of 100,000 people in America. You know, so that's the aura of the boot room and the mysticism. But as Roy Evans said, it was like people sitting around discussing players, discussing tactics. Kenny says that what he wanted in the manager's office, he didn't want new furniture, he wanted a bar. So managers could come into there. So that was really the start of the breakup of that philosophy, I think, you know. The assistant managers would go in the boot room still, but the likes of Ferguson and Clough would be going into Kenny's manager's office with the bar, you know. And the reality was, I think the breakup of the boot room started in Kenny's second year, effectively, because... They needed a new press room for the Premier League in 92. Yeah. But for me, people like Jeff Twentyman were integral to the boot room because he was scouting the players they were talking about.
Yes.
You know, so he'd scout them, and then Tom Saunders would look at them as well, and then the boot room would go and look at them to have the final decision, you know. And that's how most of the greats came to Anfield. Twentyman was in, when he was 55 in 1986, I think, he was encouraged to leave. And then Chris Lawler, who was reserve team manager, was sacked. For me, that was the start of the breakup because... Mm. Before that, everyone was becoming the manager to keep their jobs,
to keep
the boot room's jobs, you know. So that was I think that was the boot room being marginalised.
Yeah.
And I think Souness was blamed for the dismantling of the boot room. But Kenny does mention it in his book. He dedicates five pages in the book to talking about the boot room. He says, people say I dismantled the boot room, but I didn't know that.
I didn't know that.
But obviously that was the word around the corridors in Anfield at the time, you know, because of Twentyman and Chris Lawler. So I think they were trying to move on from the boot room days of sawdust on the floor and beer crates. And they saw Kenny as the man to do that, you know. And obviously Kenny's team from the late 80s, it's one of the greatest teams I've ever seen, you know. Yeah. But I think it was ironic, though. I think allegedly his last recommendations was Barnes, Beardsley and Aldridge, Twentyman's, you know. In the late 80s, certainly on the terraces, and I mentioned this, that we were thinking, these aren't good enough for Liverpool, the likes of Jimmy Carter and Speedy and that. And I think the recruitment policy had waned a bit, you know.
Yeah.
And I think... But the boot room was on its last legs anyway. I think, you know, it was people had either retired or died, you know, the passage of time.
Shankly wasn't really the boot room. He was more out there.
Yeah, yeah.
Paisley was the boot room,
you
know, and that his personality. I interviewed again at his home, as I say, long after he retired, and the man in slippers, the Al Cardi, you know, the Racing Post. Bill Cream, the telly, his missus going off to work, bizarrely.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
A little semi-dashed house. And he, at the time, was the most successful manager in English football by a mile, you know.
Yeah.
And that sums up the boot room. Simplicity.
Roy Evans emphasised that. It was the simplicity of it all. The pictures tell the story. But, you know, hopefully in the book, the narrative, I've tried to do with the narrative, is collect all the stories of the boot room from all the various autobiographies. Mm. And piece them together because it's like a jigsaw, really.
Yeah, yeah.
For me, it was like Cluedo because
I
didn't realise what had happened to some of the people, you know.